Hey, what's up guys? This is Anthony from Anthony's Customs, and for this review, we are looking at the Marvel Legends Agent Phil Coulson. This is a figure, or a character, that people wanted a figure of for a long time, and once they showed it, people were pretty happy about that, and now we finally got him in that new 3-pack. He is pretty darn good. I'm really happy about this figure for the most part. Let's go ahead and take a look at him. He stands about 6 1/4 inches tall, or just shy of 16 centimeters. He comes with this gun. This is the gun that he shot Loki with in the Avengers. Doesn't have a whole lot of paint on there. Most of it is just this black, but it's really well sculpted. And it does have a little bit of paintwork in there for the light up effect. It's got some orange and yellow. Not the best paint job, but it'll do. It'll suffice. A little silver on there might be nice, but it's definitely okay. And then he has two alternate heads. He has this head, which is not the one that comes on him. Obviously, this is the sunglasses head, and I think this head is just about perfect. Obviously, the paint isn't 100%, but it's definitely good enough, and if someone wanted to touch it up, it would be just fine. The sculpt, I think, you can't really do much better than that. It looks exactly the way it should. It looks just like him. They even have a little bit of that crooked nose going on that he has. I think they've captured the likeness extremely well on this head. On the other head, it's not quite as good. It's got kind of a goofy look to him. I'm not sure if he's supposed to be smiling or not, because his eyebrows are kind of furrowed. But then, I don't know, it's just kind of an odd look. It definitely looks like him, but there's something off about it, and it's kind of narrow. I think it might have been pinched in the mold, maybe. I don't know how that works. I don't think you can pinch him, because I'm pretty sure they use steel mold, but I don't know. Something looks a little bit off. It's not bad, but I definitely think that the sunglasses look is a much better option. It's definitely a much better likeness. So, it's not bad, but this one's definitely better, so I'm going to leave that one on him for sure. Now we have basically a whole new body to look at. I believe the hand, at least this hand, I think has been used before, but now that I look at it closer, maybe it hasn't. Either way, it's at least mostly new, maybe 100% new, and it's mostly really good. As far as paint details, we don't have a whole lot going on for the main body. It's just a black suit, so that's fine. We do have a little bit of variation in the plastic finish. Most of it's kind of like a satin look, and then the arms are a little glossy. I didn't even notice that until the hard lights just came on for the review, so it's not something I would worry about. His pants definitely do have a different finish to them. They match the lower arms. Whether that was intentional or not, I don't know, but again, it's not something I would really worry about. And if you were really worried about that, then you could just hit it with some dull coat, and then that would be fine, but it's not something I'm going to worry about. They did paint the belt on him, so that's much appreciated. And then they painted this tie. It's metallic, so I guess it's supposed to look like a silk tie, so that's cool. Just the light blue is metallic, the other blue is not, but that's fine. And then it is a separate piece, so that the ab crunch will still work on his inside body, which is made to look like a button front t-shirt, or not t-shirt, a button front t-shirt, a button front shirt for under his suit. So it all looks good. I really like the sculpt work on the suit jacket. The arms look pretty good. The pants, they look mostly pretty good. One thing I found odd about them is the way they're connected. The hips are turned in, and you can't turn them out. So in order to line up the pants all the way, you have to make him kind of knock-kneed looking. So that's a little odd. Obviously, it's not a big deal, but it is strange that these don't line up at that cut joint. So it's going to detract a little bit from the aesthetic. It's not a huge deal, though. And then the lower part of the pants, they hang a little funny. They don't quite look like suit pants. They look a little bit like cowboy pant jeans that are going to be bunched up on top of some boots. So that's a little odd also. Again, it's not a huge deal, but it's something to note. I know when I wear suit pants, they don't look like that. They hang mostly straight, and they're not going to be bunched up like that. And then lastly, we have these feet that are sculpted to look like his business shoes or his suit pant shoes type of thing. Dress shoes, and they are technically okay, but they're kind of big. They look really big on him, so they also add to that cowboy boot look. And then they also have a really strange joint design, but we'll look at that in a minute. So let's do that. There's really nothing else to talk about other than the articulation. So the head, thankfully, has the hinge, so he can look up just fine, look all the way down, and then we have the side to side. You can lean the head even a little bit to give him some attitude in his posing. And just as I'm looking at it, it really does look just like him. So really great job on that head sculpt. I absolutely love it. And then the suit, I didn't really mention it, but I kind of showed you. It is a separate piece, so it's not going to get in the way of the torso articulation. You can lean him forward. You can lean him back. You're going to have to force it a little bit, but he's poseable and definitely more than enough for what you're going to need for Coulson. The shoulder is basically a standard Marvel Legends shoulder, but it's sculpted not so much like a ball, so it is going to be limited. You can't bring the arm too far out. And it looks really good when it's just in the relaxed pose. Once you start to bring the arm out like this, it does kind of separate a bit, and you'll see in the photos at the end, I'll put the gun in his hand, and it does kind of detach the shoulder from the suit jacket up here, but that's just the nature of things, so I wouldn't worry about that too much. We do have the bicep swivel, double jointed elbow, so that's good. Decent range of motion on that. Also, sometimes doesn't want to go all the way, but you can bend the arm all the way you need to, no problem at all. The wrists both have a swivel and a hinge in them, so that's pretty nice. He can hold the gun just fine with his trigger finger. This hand, it doesn't quite line up to hold the secondary handle of this gun very well, but it's okay. I mean, it'll suffice. And if you wanted to, I think it was really intended to hold it like this, but you can't really do that because the hands are not that big. You have to really stretch it. So you're gonna have to play with that a little bit, but no big deal. We do have a waist twist, so that's fine. Standard hip style, or hip joints for the new style of Legends. He actually has pretty decent range of motion, especially enough for Agent Coulson, so no problem there. You already saw the thigh swivel. Double jointed knees, definitely not the best looking knee joint in the world, but he's probably not going to be that much, he's not going to be in that much of a dynamic pose anyway, so I guess it's not that big of a deal. For the ankles, we do have a hinge. It's very limited due to the sculpt of the pants, so that's a little disappointing. And now we can talk about that weird ankle joint, which gives us, it's our ankle rocker, which is good, but the way they designed it, it just looks really weird. The way it's just the sole of the shoe on top of this kind of ball. It's not sculpted really at all up there, so it looks really odd. And then, like I said, the feet are kind of big, and they look a little bit like cowboy boots. So the feet do detract a little bit, but obviously they're just the feet, so they don't detract that much because everything else looks really good, and I'm more than happy with this figure. Easily the best of that three pack, not only because it's Agent Coulson and we already got a Fury and the other figure is pretty garbage, but this one is really good, so definitely stick around for the photos at the end. Even though I'm not going to have him posed too crazily, you'll see that he does look really good, and I definitely recommend him a 100%. Thanks for watching, guys. Make sure you check out Big Bad Toy Store. It's where I get most of my collectibles, and I think you will be pleasantly surprised with them if you haven't shopped with them before. So thanks for watching. Make sure you subscribe to the channel so you can see my upcoming figure reviews, custom figures, and other good stuff. And in the meantime, keep collecting.